Today, I want to talk about why hot glue is your best friend, and I want to test out this new cool black hot glue that I got in the mail. Dude, I wish I had every color, but just as of a couple weeks ago, I discovered that they have a different color than this, which will help me make it visible when I do stuff like protecting circuits. So, well, I really should clean this off before I get started, but this gun has really treated me nice. It was a good investment of only, I don't know, 10 or 20 bucks, and way more manageable than those cheap, small, drippy ones. So I'm gonna use cotton to wipe this thing off. I don't have to do this often, but once in a while. Also, the plastic, I'm sure, is different. Anyway, here's why I use it. I find exposed contacts that I'm not gonna have to mess with anymore in my design, and then I just put some hot glue on there, and A, it's easy to remove it later if I don't like it, and B, this is a wonderful way to protect against short circuits in your robots. So boom, it's handled. And if I want it to be more beautiful, I grab the tool that I already use for electronics for heat shrink heating and turn that guy on, and then you can re-melt it so that it lays down nice and flat. It's not even that bad in the first place, but you can smooth it out and you can get rid of the small strings this way. See, like right here? Let's see if we can re-melt it and make it lay down. Okay, level two. Okay, so I smoothed it out and now it's totally covering the contact, but I have a feeling the black hot glue is a higher melting temperature than the regular one here. So be careful not to melt your plastic parts when you're using the heat gun. And also after you're done, this is still pretty warm. It might not be melting, but it might be warping. So set it somewhere where there's no forces on it, and let it cool down where it won't lose its shape. You wouldn't want to clamp this to something right now. Now I'll come over here, do the other bracket. I don't even need to unattach it. Oh, it flows with resistance and then suddenly it jumps out. So be careful, but if you mess up, this stuff is pretty easy to peel off. I won't show that in the video because I don't want to go backwards. But yeah, the next thing is my I2C board, which I didn't have the glue before, so I just put a piece of tape here. Obviously, when it's nested in the robot, it's protected, but until you get it put away, and any time that you manipulate things, if your circuits can come loose, then your circuits are not safe. You don't want to risk toasting the $15 encoders which are on this channel. So it's very important. And then this layer that I'm applying here, it's got to lay pretty low, so I'll probably apply it and then reheat it. Otherwise it'll be too large for the gap between my board and the plastic bracket. Obviously you'll have to peel this off if you want to solder that final row, which I did not solder intentionally. I didn't need those. And Let gravity do its job. And now I've covered up, I'm tempted to touch it, covered up all the pins, except for just a tiny spot on that one. That's okay. I'll leave it upside down and hopefully it'll cool, not too thick. I almost forgot to say why the color even matters of these glues. At Toyota, we did 5S. Sort, straighten, shine, standardize, sustain. And in Japanese, it's another 5S words. But anyway, what you have when you use the regular hot glue is a decent coverage, but it's semi see-through and sort of not. And so it's not super clear whether you've coated it clearly or whether there's damage on the hot glue. Now, why does that matter? Well, in a system where you have 1,000 different things going on at the same time, you want to give yourself every opportunity to detect something that's not sorted or that's not shining. So if you crash your robot and you damage the coating on that's covering these pins, that's your one opportunity to notice that there's a problem or an upcoming problem before the problem happens. Every different upgrade, like different colored glue, is a potential benefit or a potential upgrade in your system, okay? But most of them are not free. I love finding free solutions, which is like this one. The change in cost is nothing, but what I have is a much nicer looking coating. And also, I can use this as a piece of communication. If I see the black hot glue, that means this is for covering up electronics. And if I see the white hot glue, I'll know that that's for another purpose. So the black hot glue sticks are cheap and useful, and they're just as easy to use as the white ones.